all of these women are actually bi or multiracial. But get this, everybody, they hate one part of their racial identity so much that they're insulted when someone tries to make them claim that or represent that or just own that being a part of them. We're going to start with Jenna. So Jenna, you are what? Tell us what your mix is.
I am black and white. I'm biracial.
Okay, so you're black and white, biracial.
But I only claim the white side.
You only claim the white side?
Yeah.
Okay, so you only claim the white side. I think the audience, why are we grumbling, audience? Anybody? Stand on up. I have a feeling.
She looks black, that's why. So I would,
Yes. Jenna?
There's a difference between looking black and you don't have to be black. I'm not just black. I am white, too. I don't just only show my white side.
Yes.
Or my black side. I mean...
Tell me about black people and what they mean to you and how you feel about black people.
I don't care for them. I really don't. It's just, I don't care for them for the way they act, the way they talk. They just kind of seem to do their own thing, and they're unpredictable. One minute they can be, you know, themselves. And it's not all black people. It's just mainly inner city blacks that I'm scared to death of.
I'm scared of them. You're scared of black people?
Yeah.
Okay, and tell me about babysitting. I understand there's certain kids you won't babysit.
Yeah, I won't babysit black kids because they're crazy. They're loud.
Okay. So, Jenna, when you look in the mirror, what do you see? Tell me what you see when you look in the mirror.
Me? I see me. I don't see a color.
No, Jenna, you're not colorblind, so you do see a color.
I do see a color.
So what color do you see when you look in the mirror? I'm not talking about spiritually, figuratively, inside. I'm talking about with your eyes when you look in the mirror.
I would love to see white.
But what do you see?
I see black.
Okay. So tell me why you would love to see white. Tell me what makes you upset.
Because
that you
they
see
have
black.
A higher standard in America. They are
higher standard. Okay.
Yeah. Or if I was even just lighter skinned, I would just have a higher, personality. I don't want to say personality, but I would have a higher being.
A higher being.
I would be more important. I'd be more accepted in the way I live my life.
Okay. Now tell me about, there's a certain flag that you carry and that you
sport.
Yeah,
I have my rebel flag.
Explain what a rebel flag is.
It just means...
I guess we don't have to explain what a rebel flag is.
No, it's just a flag. There is nothing serious about it. I mean, people need to get over it. It never meant, you know, that's why I don't like being claimed as black, because it doesn't mean... You know, just because you're white and you have a rebel flag, you're racist.
You have that flag for a reason.
Yeah, I have it because it's just, it's part of me. It's a part of my culture. It's just a part of me. It's who I am.
Do you understand that the people that carried that flag years and years ago, hundreds of years ago, the people that carried that flag wanted to burn you? Do you understand
that?
But see,
I look at it as, you know, that was in the past, okay? Get over it. Step up, do something different, get over it. It's a flag.
Okay, so tell me where you carry that flag.
I have two in my bedroom and I had one in my car.
One in your car?
Yeah.
And then you go to rodeos?
I go to the rodeo. I love the rodeo. Like one time I went to the rodeo. I mean, I'm not always accepted. I went to the rodeo and everybody looked at me like, what is she doing here, you know? There's no reason for her to be here. But when I finally just sat down, put my chew in and just relaxed, they were like, you know, she's just like us. I mean,
and do you carry the flag at the rodeo?
Oh no, I have every year it's turned into a tradition where I at the fair right after a showing or sometime I will run around the fair with my rebel flag and just everybody's behind me cheering and everything. There's nothing.
Okay. And tell me about, you were at the bowling alley one day and you called a girl something.
Well, I was at the bowling alley and this girl had started in on me, like, you know, calling me, oh, so you think you're a white girl and everything. And then all of a sudden...
What race was she?
She was mixed.
Okay.
She was awesome. She was lighter than I was.
Okay, mixed with black and white?
Yes.
Okay.
And she was like, you know, like, oh, so you think you're a white girl. And the next thing you know, she started in with the N-word. And she was like, N-word. And I'm like, what do you mean? Like, what are you talking about? And I just go, I said it, you know? And to me...
But you called her that or she called you that?
Well, I don't understand how it came about, period, though. She just kind of came out and said it.
And then
I said it back to her.
Okay.
Okay? And then, but to me, the N-word does not just mean a black person.
I did a show on bleaching.
Yes.
About black women bleaching their skin because they hated their skin so much. How many people saw that show? You guys saw that show? Okay. Okay, a lot of you guys saw that show. Okay, so you saw that show. What did you think when you saw that show?
I was so happy. I was like, it shows, you know, it helped me.
So that show was a tutorial for you?
Yeah.
Not a message of something being negative and can cause...
No.
Damage to your skin, damage to your health?
No.
Damage to your well-being and your spirit?
No, it didn't because, I mean, I want to be lighter. My brother is lighter than I am. I want to be like him. That's how he is, you know? Okay. I wish I could be as light as he is.
I think something happened when you were young that is making you feel this way. We're going to go to a break in a little bit, but before we do, I want to show everybody a picture of Jenna. So, explain this photo.
If you read,
it looks like
it
a KKK. It looks like a KKK mask.
It's made out of a pair of jeans. I hang out in the parking lot. We hang out. It's a total joke. It even says, JK, JK, it's just a joke. I mean,
so when you do something that's...
To me, it's just a joke. It's nothing serious. I look at it and I laugh. I'm like, whatever, dude, get over yourself. And
so Jenna, it's not a joke. It doesn't matter. A lot of people say that and they try to use that as an excuse to do something crazy and then say, oh, I was just joking. You hate yourself. You want to bleach yourself. You carry a rebel flag. You do not like the black side of you. You look in the mirror and you want to see white. You put on a KKK mask and say that's just a joke. That's not a joke. It's a serious issue.